Do you want to hear the personal statement that got me into Cambridge? Let's go.
To cultivate my understanding of French literature, I began by reading Le Petit Prince. I analyzed Saint-Exupéry's exploration of complex philosophical issues from the simple viewpoint of a child in an essay for a school essay competition. Furthermore, I have enjoyed comparing Pangloss's optimism in Candide and Meursault's belief in absurdist atheism in L'Étranger. I became captivated by the widespread censorship of Candide, so I explored this theme further in my IRP on secularism, where the religious freedom of French citizens is arguably censored. So, what about this middle paragraph of my personal statement captured the attention of the admissions team? Firstly, I had a relevant introduction to cultivate my understanding of French literature. This signposts the admissions team. I'm showing them, hey, I'm an ideal candidate because I'm going to be great at this part of the course. Additionally, the structure of my personal statement was based around the course of my favorite university, Cambridge. I knew that the Cambridge Modern Languages course focused not only on literature and culture, but also on using the foreign languages. So, earlier on in the statement, I'd mentioned what I'd done to deepen my knowledge of the language part, but now I knew I needed to talk about literature. Applying for French and Spanish, I knew it was important to mention both of these parts. So I'd done another paragraph on Spanish culture and literature, and then this paragraph on French literature. This means that anyone who read my personal statement knew I would excel in any part of the course. Furthermore, this personal statement explains my academic journey. What sparked my interest, and then what did I do after that to carry on learning more? This shows independent learning and research skills, which are crucial for a university student. I also showed my journey by linking what I'd done to my studies at school. I mentioned specialist technical terms, such as absurdist atheism. Finally, I situated my observations of classical French literature in a modern context by mentioning how, nowadays, religious freedom is censored. You do not need to do this last point, but I thought that comparing to a modern context or another context shows why you're still interested in the subject.